and our ancestors has been through so much that this moment that we are experiencing right now is a part of it. Yes. So for Rastafari to be in tourism, our ancestors call this tourism. Yes. Something that prostitutes the land, it prostitutes the people. You know, so this is a big decision, and your behavior and conduct is going to be important, because our doors are open now, but we are being advised by the interactions of how, if they continue to. Yes? Because Rastafari is a living heritage with real experiences. And it is an experience that belongs to the human family, which would have allowed us to interact again with the human family at this level. The transatlantic slave period is definitely a defining time in human existence, something that we can't all deny. This is something where, you know, the world was caught up in sugar, sweet, and I think it created a diabetic type of approach to humanity. It was so sweet. It got us all sick. And within that whole essence is how African people would have come into this space. And Rastafari would have represented the non-acceptance of that journey. It may have had other names in other times, because we cannot deny the indigenous people of Jamaica who were labeled indigenous, which is the Maroons, and their journey that they came through. It is the same spirit of rebellion that would have brought forward to who we are today as Rastafari. Rastafari, would we say, started as the name connects to a people with a particular energy in 1930 on November 2nd, when Haile Selassie was crowned in Ethiopia as King of Kings, Lords of Lords, conqueror land of the tribe of Judah. All of these titles, King of Kings, Lords of Lords, conqueror land of the tribe of Judah, are titles that we learn of through the Bible. And the Bible was definitely the main book that the colonizers used, and that was considered to be the moral principle of humanity. It does carry a lot of things in there. And it was also important towards the historical components. In that, these names, King of Kings, Lords of Lords, are popular names in the Bible, which refer to the all-creating power, the highest, which is God. And Haile Selassie was really the first man that we know that was crowned under these titles to date. Because ever since Haile Selassie left the throne of Ethiopia, no one else has sat on this throne. So to date, is the only man that we know that was crowned under these names and under these titles. A very special thing happened with the African people in Jamaica, which is called Rastafari, which didn't happen to all of the other spaces that were colonized. That's because Canada is also part of the British Commonwealth or something like that, you know, a colony of England as well. So this went through, and a lot of the Native Americans were colonized with the Bible. The Bible was the main book. But what happened to Rastafarian African people was that in Jamaica, we end up owning the story, while the Indians could not do that. We own the story because it was talking about a region that we are from. It called names like Ethiopia and was definitely in the east. So as a result of that, we realized that this great story was a great story about ourselves. So the Bible actually gave us a lot more confidence than the colonizers would have wanted, because we realized it was our story, it was African's story. So we started to own the story, not in the way how King James Version would have placed it, but own it in a way that it was from us and this is what it meant. So the Bible was redefined by us. So it was that main component, and Haile Selassie and his crowning was a main component. But when we met Haile Selassie himself, we realized that this was a special human being. And this special human being would have given us an identity, like, you know how Caucasian would have Jesus Christ in their own image? The Buddha would have the Indian in their own image that they looked up. Chinese. Then this meant that the African man, in his own image, had an identity that he could recognize with and call divine. So to be Rastafari, it is the acceptance of the divinity of Haile Selassie. And that does not stop any race, yes, or color, or persons. Before, when the movement just started, it was a black movement. The black man redemption. But when we met Haile Selassie, he said we must become members of a new race, which is the human race. He said until the philosophy which holds one race inferior and another superior is finally and totally discredited and abandoned, there will always be war. So through Haile Selassie, we became universal citizens. We saw God in all things. This is why when Rastafari speak about one love. Bob Marley, good brethren. But he's just another Rastaman. He just was poetic and put the philosophy in a way that connected. So yeah, to the king of reggae. Yes? But Bob Marley, the impression that people got from it was that it was one love between human beings. But for us, it's a cosmical love. The earth, the grass, the birds, human beings. Are extension of one part that we are all a part of. And that is what Rastafari and the divinity of Haile Selassie means to us. Yeah, so that's a very, very important symbol to us as Rastafari. We drifted away from the Bible in many ways and only saw it as a good book, because most of the movements, indigenous, religious or otherwise, seem to suppress the energy of women. I don't know, from ancient days, no matter which culture you go in, there seems to be most cultures suppress the energy of women. Christianity the same, apart from saying Holy Mary, Mother Jesus of Christ or something like that, there is still the woman has to be subjected to the man and all these kind of things. Haile Selassie broke that tradition 3,000 years of crowning the emperor and the empress on the same day. This was profound for us. Very, very profound. Why did he do this? And it was to restore the balance of male and female. So this is why as Rastafari, we do not embrace the cross. We see the cross as a symbol of death and crucifixion. So we embrace the ancient Egypt symbol. Do you know this symbol? You know the name of it? It's called the Ankh. The important thing is that at the top, it has a, you see, there's an opening. It's not straight like the cross. And this refers to the highest energy, the feminine energy, the womb, at the top, in the rightful place. So that was ancient Egyptology. Yeah? And then here, would refer to as the fallopian tubes, our children. And here, the energy of destruction, male energy. Yeah, we think that all the problems exist within humanity. Patriarchal energy has been the one that has caused this. Slavery, racism, wars, man, male energy. Yes. I'm not a man. It's important. I am a human being, which means I'm my mother and my father at the same time. So I'm not a man. Yes, so here is that energy, the male energy. Important, but dangerous. So yes, together here you have mother, father, and child. Yes, and that is important for the creation of life. Now in Christianity, they have the father, they have the son, not a daughter. And when the woman should come in, what did they do? Put in a dumping. Ghost. So we do not embrace
that. It's so true.
Yeah, uh-huh. So we don't. Which brings me to the herbs, the source of thinking. Yes, people call it mind altering, and I agree. I wanted to alter my mind this way and in this direction. I quite like it, to have a cosmical love. But the philosophy of Rastafari was built on the herbs. The herbs in the beginning was never used for personal, it was for a reason. So it was always when you gather, you would build up the pipe, you would light it, and you pass it around to each person. And then reasoning of every topic you could think of would come up. And it is through these reasonings the foundation of Rastafari is developed. Everything in the system that was ever said is analyzed, including Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, through the herbs. Yes? So everything is analyzed and our own pathway is created. Now, this don't mean that everyone has to smoke herb. That has already been done, has created the guiding principles. Now people smoke the selfish one, which is the slip. But this is the internal reason, which is as equal as the external reason. Meaning a space by yourself. Rastafari was declared to me as the revelation of yourself to yourself. You need to have that conversation. That's important. So yeah, so Haile Selassie, the main guiding principle of Rastafari. I want you to do this. This symbol is called a trinity, representing heat, air and water, sun, moon and star, mother, father and child. Three. Heat, air and water, three. Sun, moon and star, three. Mother, father and child, three. Then together, three. Yes? So three is a very, very important number to us. And those principles are what we see to create energy, to ensure that life continues to exist. So as a result of that, we do not go outside of this principle because it's a continuation. We see our journey here is to ensure that it is always prepared for those who are here, who have been here and who are coming. Yes? So this is important to us, to guide for these principles to guide us. So I showed you the Ankh. I told you about Rastafari, which is Haile Selassie, I crowd in Ethiopia. I gave you the Trinity. Now I will speak to you about the colors. The red, the gold, and the green. Of course, three again. Now the black is the source. And that's always a color that is recognized with us as Rastafari. The yellow, all Rastafari have their own interpretation of everything. This is a living heritage. What I tell you today that represents us, tomorrow may not be so. Which means that we are real. Yes? Because there's only one thing that is sure, it's change. We pretend that it's not happening. But I'm very sure you were not born this way. Yeah. So, we have our own interpretation because this group is called the Ion Station. IION is an acronym for Indigenous Initiating Circle of Nature. The operative word is initiating, meaning that we never stop. You're never initiated. You're always learning, growing, knowing more. Yes? So, we refuse to be held accountable for anything that I tell you now, and you see me tomorrow. Yes, so yellow, representing the sunshine. Yes? The red, representing the people on the land, the blood. And the green, representing all of life forms. Yes? So this is important to us. And of course, black is the source. And that's how we see it. Yes? Also, the fire. The fire is one of the most important symbols to us as Rastafari, even though all the symbols are important. Because when you go to a Rastafari ritualistic space, you'll always see fire burning. It's not cooking anything. It's just there as a symbol of purity, a reminder of your journey, and the fact that you need to purify your journey for yourself. So this is important to us, the fire. A lot of things that we meet on our journey that is not pure, is we call it Babylon. Babylon is any system of governance or behavior within individual that is out of balance. And we put it to the fire because the fire for us represents an agent of change. Transform things from one stage to another. So we say, fire upon Babylon, which simply means that we want it to go away. Yeah, man. So, if there is a behavior within your partner that you don't like, fire upon! Practice, tell him.
Fire upon!
Yeah. I don't know. Yes, exactly. But a kiss must follow after.
You know, just look, you must give me.
Yeah, you need water. You need water to ensure that it balances out. Yeah, yeah. Because if you do fire and a slap, it may go too hard. It's a forceful energy. Yeah, man. So water is important. Yeah, man. So these symbols are very important. Yes, Rastafari is not a religion. Now, some Rastafari may tell you otherwise, but all Rastafari will say it is a way of life. Which means for us, Rastafari is not a religion, but a relation. A relationship, and sometimes that is too big. So it's a relation boat between everything that exists. Yes, Rastafari makes their own words. Yes. So, tourism is one that is popular for us. Relation boat is also one that is popular for Rastafari. Rastafari does not say appreciate. They do not understand the energy 8 in a world of gratitude. So they say appreciate love. Rastafari do not say oppress. They don't see anything upwards in it. In terms, you must understand that language for us is sound. Because sound is the vibration, it's not the spelling, it's a vibration that it brings. So as a result of that, it's a vibration that we want. Something that can allow those who are more intelligent than structural reading and writing to still understand and communicate on the highest level. So we say down pressure instead of up pressure. We do not understand something, we don't think that if you comprehend and you have a fullness of what is being said, you could still be under it. So we say overstand. On this moment we will stand. Stand, let me teach you a good Rastafari word.